Jake says the water is freezing.
Off with him.
Gimmicky, but
wow.
It makes it worth it.
Now that is cool, guys.
From each corner now. Pull.
Oh, you mean like that?
Yep. No, pull it, no, pull it. I'm trying to stretch it out. That's as far as it goes, isn't it?
How's it going, guys? Another camping video here today. Back at the same spot we went in the last video. However, we decided to pinch up camp just a little bit further from where we went last time, which is just down there. This video is gonna be an interesting one today. We're gonna go into town, and then we're going to carve a jack-o'-lantern as well later in this video, as you'll see. So grab yourselves a drink, grab yourselves something to eat or a snack, make yourselves comfortable and enjoy the video, guys, because this is going to be a good one. So I've got our wood all sorted out here for tonight. I intend to make a stew, which you'll see later on in the video. I intend to make a stew tonight. Might even add some Guinness to it or something. We need to go into town later, so I might just do that. Tonight I'm just running the regular setup of the swag tent made of canvas. Slept in it last night. It was okay. To be honest, I didn't get much sleep. Never really do in the first night. And I just have my container. And yeah, all I really need, to be honest. As for my friend here, he's got a total different setup to mine. He has a tent. An instant, what?
Instant up tent.
Okay. Can we get a tour of your crib?
Sure.
Alrighty.
So this storage.
Got a nice little kitchen here.
In there.
Kitchen bench.
I did have a bed of esky. It doesn't look that nice, but my sister borrowed mine and didn't clean it out, and there's mold in my esky. So this one doesn't have a proper seal gasket thing, so I'm just using a shirt and my water jug just to keep it shut.
Now for the entrance of this sweet crib.
Yeah. A lot bigger than I was expecting it when it came, but this is it.
Hey, it's pretty good.
What's cool about it?
Show us the main feature of this.
Well, the main feature is if you're at night and it's dark, and I'm a tall person, if I have a lantern there, I'm going to whack my head. But it has an integrated lighting system.
Integrated lighting system.
Which is a bit gimmicky, but at night,
wow.
It makes it worth it.
Now that is cool, guys. How many tents have that system? Not many, huh?
Only a few. It's the little things that count.
Like, yeah.
I don't whack my head on anything. I don't whack my head on the lantern, which I like. And all it takes is just a power bank.
Wow. And just a power bank.
Power bank. Easy. Plug it in.
So you don't need to plug it into a, you know, what do you call those power sockets?
You can see at traditional campsites. Because it has a USB.
But USB will do just fine as well. That's cool. It's not too bad in here. Like, I can stand up. Yeah. I'm not cramped or anything. And it fits two people here quite nice. I think we should probably let in some airflow, however. I'll let you do that. But this is a nice... I really like it. I think it's a really nice setup you have. And I might even get one. Ah, that's better. Okay, we're gonna head into town. And I'll bring you guys along with. Gave us a brochure, $28 for a 2-hour trip to and back from Pinjarra or somewhere. Yeah. I'm genuinely interested, to be honest with you. I wouldn't mind doing it. So, we didn't jump on the train, because Jake here did bring his shoes, and they said they'd go on a bush hike. That's okay. We may or we may not come back and jump on a train. That would be interesting if we did, though. But yeah, cool little brochure. Train. Okay. Yeah, pretty cool. Jake and I are gonna check out this shop called Waypoint. Wow, that's a very orange car. What are you looking at, Jake? A truck. Hey, Kia. Isn't that a prison?
cameras.
Whole range of camping stuff.
$13. Not bad.
Oh, the other one is 10.
So that was shop waypoint. We're gonna head back and make some lunch, I reckon. I'm starving. So just got back from the shop, got myself some flour. I think I'm gonna make a stew in a couple of hours. But for now, I think I'm just gonna have some lunch, make some sausages, some hot dogs, and just chill. So, what's this contraption here, you wonder? This is the B6 barbecue compact, sorry. This is the B6 compact grill by Sho, which is a Japanese company which makes these. And in all honesty, they are pretty good. I've already oiled the top of it. Today I'm using coals. They give quite a lovely taste. But yeah, usually you can just open up like that. You don't really need to take the top off. And you just feed it in. And you know, Bob's your uncle, Sheila's your aunt. We've got flame grill going. Now, I know this is cheating, but you know, why make camping more harder for yourself than it needs to be? Right from the fact that the smoke's getting in my face here, I'd say that's good to cook on. So, without further ado, let's throw some snags on. Now, I think the fire's just died out in this. It's no bother. You seem a little bit charred. Oh God. I think I may have overdone these. Alright, so I didn't do too well in the first two sausages there. As you can see, burnt to an absolute crisp. This one, however, looks about done. So I'm going to turn it over. Yeah, that looks decent. That's what I call a sausage. So I'm going to put this in some bread and apply some tomato sauce and enjoy. Alright, after a hot, very hearty lunch, we've decided to come down to this river here, I suppose you could call it, and try out the paddleboard, which Jake has here. So I think I'll probably watch, maybe I'll have a go at it, and yeah, I'll get some footage on a drone. Surf's up. So Jake says the water is freezing. Off with him. Try not to get dunked by any waves. Thank you.